Hi, and welcome to the next section of my video series on how to use markers within Logic Pro and Mainstage. In the first section, which we covered off in two videos, we showed how to create a Logic project, build a song, and then use markers to delineate the different sections of that song. And in the final piece of that, we bounced the audio file down, and by bouncing it down, it would embed the marker track within that audio file. So the next section that we're going to look at is then using that audio file as a for playback within Mainstage using the playback plugin. And we'll then use the markers within that audio file to just navigate through the file within Mainstage and then map a external MIDI controller, and in this case it's going to be an M-Audio keyboard to it. It could be anything. And that'll allow us to externally control how we navigate through the plugin or the playback plugin itself. So the first thing is, let's take a look at how we would get that audio file within Mainstage. And I've already covered that off in a previous video, but I'll touch base on it right now. So what you'd do is you would insert a new channel strip within Mainstage right here, and you would go down to the I/O area here, click on it, and if you scroll down here, you'll see there's the within all the different instruments, there's a playback plugin, and then you simply choose stereo if stereo was what you wanted. That's one way of doing it. There's an easier way of doing it, which is if you locate your audio file from Finder, you can then simply drag that audio file from Finder directly into Mainstage, and Mainstage will create a new channel strip with a playback plugin within it. So let me just show you that very briefly. Just for this example, I've created a copy of the audio file on my desktop, and it's right here. So if I click and drag that over to the channel strip area of Mainstage, you'll see there's a plus sign which shows it's going to do a copy, and then that bold vertical bar will show you at which point Mainstage will insert the new channel strip. Then you just release your mouse, and it will create a new channel strip with a playback plugin within it, and it will name that channel strip to be the same name as the audio file that you've just dragged in. So that's a much easier way of doing it. So I would suggest just locating your file within Finder and then just dragging it into Mainstage, and that'll do it. Okay, we'll take a look at various parts of this, and really the first part that I want to just take a look at and verify that I've got the right file is to make sure that I have the marker track within the audio file that I've created. So to do that, I'll double click on the playback plugin. And if you look at this section of the playback plugin here, this blue-gray area is the marker track. And as you can see, there's the name of the first marker intro. And if you recall, we created that in our Logic Pro project. And then the next marker is verse 1. And what I want to do is just go through and double check all those markers. Now, there are two buttons that are within the transport here that are used for marker navigation are down here at the bottom right. So this button is for marker forward, and this is marker back. So if I click forward, you'll see that the playhead automatically skips to the next marker, and in our case, it's verse 1. If I click it again, it goes to the next marker, which is brass. And next marker, which is piano. And so this definitely is the file that we created. So that's the first thing you want to do is just make sure that you have the correct audio file. It does have the markers in it. And then you can just click this back, and it will navigate back through the markers. So that's just forward and back through that. Now, the next piece that we want to look at is how we would then navigate those markers within Mainstage. And there are a number of different pieces to that, and I'll just cover each one of them as we go through here. Now, what I did is I created a custom marker navigation box right here, and I created that through going into layout within Mainstage, and then just built that from the various items that are within the Mainstage palette down at the bottom. Then I finally grouped them all together and then just saved that in my palette so I can use this same marker box at a later date for any other project coming up. And I simply created it so that there are two windows at the top, and I'm going to use that for my information applicable to my current marker. And then I put in some navigation buttons for previous marker, next marker, play, pause. And then I put in eight what I would sort of call direct access or direct marker access buttons that I'm then going to map to each one of the audio markers that I have within my playback track. And then this section down at the bottom is just a navigation or informational window that will show me info for my next marker. And we'll take a look at that a little bit later. Now, after I built this, I then did the MIDI mapping to each one of these buttons. Now, I've covered MIDI mapping before in previous videos, so I won't go over it again, but just to touch on it very briefly, if you click on each one of these buttons, it'll allow you to then learn an external MIDI controller, and in this case, I've been using my M-Audio keyboard, and I simply pressed A4 for this button, and so it automatically mapped A4 to this button right here. And then the next marker is mapped to B4, and my play pause button to C5. And then each one of these buttons here, if we just go down, you'll see one is mapped to C1, D1, E1, and you can map these to anything you want. Just choose whatever. I just made it relatively straightforward and clear just for ease of communicating it here. I did the actual marker box build within here, saved it, and then I did the MIDI learning. So at this point in time, what I have is I have a box that will show me the different parts of the marker navigation. Okay, so let's just step through the different mappings of that box. So if you look at this one right here, for example, and we'll just step through. Let me just move this up to get it out of the way. What I did is I selected the marker example, which is the name of my playback plugin channel strip here, and then chose playback, status, and position. So what that will do is this window will display the current position of my current marker. And in this case, if you look at the playhead here, the playhead is positioned at the intro marker, and so it has populated that with the intro. So if we just double click on this, or rather just click on that, you'll see it's the same thing, playback, status, and then current marker name. So I've mapped this box to the current marker name. And then I did the same thing, or very similar mappings, to each one of these buttons right here. So this one, for example, in the previous, I've used marker example, playback, transport, go to previous marker. I did the same thing on the next marker button here, and then the same thing on the play pause. So on play pause, I did playback, transport, play stop current position. And then with the direct access or direct marker buttons, I mapped those to each one of my markers within the audio track.